Chapter 1, Lesson 1, The Windows 7 Environment. Welcome to Windows 7. So, what is Windows 7 actually is? Windows 7 is the most advanced operating system released by Microsoft. An operating system works like a middleman between you and the computer hardware. It takes control of each piece of your computer hardware and makes them ready for you. Your computer then start working on your commands, like a genie.
When Windows 7 starts for the first time, after a clean installation, you will be presented with this screen. Before we start our journey to Windows 7 features, first have a look on what you are having on your Windows screen.
The area, which is covered by the picture, is called the desktop. The window icon available on the left bottom corner of the screen is called the Start menu. The bar with default blue color, covering the bottom area of your screen is called the Taskbar. On the right bottom corner of your screen, the area representing the time and date with volume icon is called the System Tray.
The graphical shapes on your desktop with different names are called the icons. After a fresh installation of Windows 7, you may see only one icon representing the Recycle Bin. You can call it like the Recycle Bin icon. As you continue to watch our videos, the tutorials will be referring to several object names. So, it is important for you to remember the name of objects for improved learning. Before we start exploring the features of Windows 7, let me clear you that how I will be using the computer mouse. Most of the time, I will be clicking the left mouse button to open the objects, and whenever any command requires a right click of the mouse, I will mention it in the video.
You must remember that whenever I will say double click, that means I am pressing the left mouse button two times quickly. Here is another point to remember. Only the left click can be used twice to execute a command. I mean, whenever I will be double clicking, I will be using the left mouse button.
There is another button on your computer mouse, which is called the scroll bar. The scroll bar is used to scroll the screen up or down. The scroll bar is mostly used when your monitor screen has larger contents to display and they does not fit on the screen. Then you can scroll your screen by moving the scroll button of your mouse.
So, let's get started with our hands-on practice with live video of working with Windows 7. In our first lesson, I will be covering how things work in Windows, like how to open and close an application, how the taskbar works, how to work with the icons on desktop, and how the Start menu works.
As I mentioned earlier that you will be presented with this screen for the first time you start Windows after a fresh installation. So, if you move your mouse pointer near to the Start menu, it will display a tooltip displaying the name of the object. Clicking on the Start menu once will open it. The Start menu will then display the default programs and commands available.
There is another submenu in the Start, which is called All Programs. As you can see, the All Programs submenus has an arrow available, which is representing that if you click All Programs, then it has more programs to offer you. Clicking on All Programs will lead you to another list of programs available with Windows 7 Ultimate by default.
To close the Start menu and all its submenus, you can again click on the Start button, or you can click on an empty area of your desktop. To understand the step more clearly, we will now open a program from Start menu. To complete this task, click on Start button, then click on All Programs, then click on Accessories, and then click on WordPad. As the WordPad open, you can notice that the new icon is available on your taskbar, along with another three icons. This represent that you have an application or program open. The other three icons are available by default on your taskbar. As you open any application, the taskbar will represent its icon, notifying you that how many applications are currently open.
Now, we have learned that how to open a program, we will discuss how to close a program. To close the WordPad or any other application, you can notice that there are three default buttons are available on top right corner of the screen. You can click on the red cross button to close any application. You should also note that whenever you close an application, the icon available on the taskbar representing the open application also get invisible. So, while practicing, if you have opened any application by mistake, then you can close it by clicking on the red cross button anytime.
To understand working with application more accurately, let's talk about the other two icons that were available with the close button. The first icon is representing the minimize command. Clicking this button will minimize the application to the taskbar without closing it. As I click on the minimize button, you can notice that the word bad is still running on the taskbar. This can be used every time when you do not want to close the current application, but you want to run another command from desktop or another application. Clicking on the word pad button, available on the taskbar, will restore the application to its original state. The middle button between the minimize and close button is called the maximize button. Actually, there are two options in this single button. If you click it once, then the current application will restore to its original size, and clicking it again will maximize the application to full screen. You can also call it the restore up and restore down button. If you open an application and it is not in full screen view, clicking on maximize button will stretch the application to full screen.
Now, what is available on our Windows desktop? The Windows desktop also represents the program icons. You may have seen that there were many programs available under the Start menu. You can also put as many icons you want on your desktop as well, but it will not be a good idea to put each of your program icons on the desktop. You will mess up the desktop and you may have difficulty to identify the things. We mostly have those programs on the desktop that we use the most in our day-to-day life. As you can see, there is currently only one icon available on the desktop. To open a desktop icon, you have to double-click on it. Move your mouse pointer to the icon, and double-click the left mouse button twice. To close the recycle bin, you will use the same procedure as described earlier, clicking the close button. There are more videos to come. This is Rajiv Kohli. Stay tuned and subscribe to our channel.